In the previous slide, we have seen the plot of sensitivity versus specificity and how adjusting the threshold can increase or decrease either of them. This is a curve called receiver operating characteristic curve, wherein you plot the true positive rate against the false positive rate, or in other words, you plot the sensitivity against 100 minus specificity. This is the kind of curve that you get. So even based on these ROC curves, you can analyze how the models are performing. For example, let's take these three cases into consideration. Now this is the third model, which is able to achieve a 100% recall or 100% sensitivity, but at what cost? It made a lot of mistakes in classifying the good emails. That is, it was able to achieve 100% recall, but by compromising on the false positives. So if you plot the ROC curve for this kind of model, then you might end up with such this kind of graph that is shown in the black. That is, to achieve a sensitivity of 100%, very high sensitivity, you made lot of mistakes with respect to the false positives. A better model compared to this is the second one, wherein you are able to achieve a recall of 100% with just few mistakes. That is, you misclassified just 3 out of the good emails. So if you plot the ROC curve for this kind of model, you might get a graph that looks like this. That is, with just few false positives, you are able to reach a sensitivity or a recall of 100%. And the best kind of model will be the first case, wherein you made just one mistake and was able to achieve a recall of 100%. So in such cases, your model's ROC curve might look like this. So it's like almost like a straight line, a reverse L-shaped curve, wherein with just one mistake, that is one false positive, you are able to reach a sensitivity or recall of 100%. So even by plotting the ROC curves of your models, you should be able to differentiate a good one from a bad one.